So let's start with our plotting libraries. And for that, first, let's look again at the datasets. So we've seen the cars dataset here. We see this is a clean dataset. We have one variable per column and per row where we have one sample. And well, we've already looked at this exploratively, so I'm not going to explain this anymore. And sometimes we're also going to look at the Titanic dataset, which also is clean and has one sample per row. All right, we've already looked at pandas plotting last week. Philip did already with you. So this here is how this pandas plot normally looks like, or a plot generally for Matplotlib. However, know that Matplotlib allows many different styles, especially once we have imported and installed, for example, Seaborn or ggplot. And we see here that many of the styles we could use are coming from Seaborn, or even from this ggplot in here too. And we can tell Matplotlib to use a certain style. So this is the standard style. We can also use the classic style here. And this should not confuse you. Once you have called the method seaborn.set, it automatically uses, so pandas plotting automatically uses the seaborn style, which I personally like much more than the basic style. So just know that even your standard plotting has a style which can be influenced by the libraries we're going to look at. But yeah, I'm not going to go into detail about pandas plotting because Philip already explained that to you. You simply can call .hist or .plot on data frames or series. So let's start with ggplot. We start with it because it best conveys the idea of the grammar of graphics. So, what is the grammar of graphics?